everyone. Welcome to She Codes. She Codes is a video blog series of Perfect, where we bring out the voice of super talented female techies. And today, we have for the first time a final year student who was very excited to be part of our series.
Hello everyone. Thank you so much, Swati, for inviting me. I'm Neha Agarwal. I'm a final year BTech computer science student from UPS Dehradun. My hometown is in West Bengal and I have a family of five. I have my parents, my brother and a sister. So I started coding when I was in class 9. I used to code in Java. So earlier I used to think that coding is all about giving you a problem statement. You design an algorithm for it and then you code it in a language which is understandable by the machine. That is any language like Java, C++, C. So I loved coding and I decided to pursue BTech in computer science as my higher studies. So when I entered college, I came to know, okay, you just don't need to solve problem statements, but there are tons of other things which you can do. You can develop applications, you can develop websites, you can combine and study about technologies such as machine learning, artificial intelligence, neural networks, blockchain, develop games, do augmented reality, tons of stuff. So I really got very excited and I decided, okay, I have to explore at least some of them. And then I started with web development. I was learning website development online and I was developing small web pages on my own. Then I decided, okay, I think I should apply for internships. I'll get a better exposure of the corporate world and I'll know what is actually needed, what skills are actually needed in website development in the and I will also get an opportunity to work in a bigger project. So I got an internship in a startup in Delhi named Acropolis Infotech Private Limited. I developed an e-commerce website application there and the amount of learning I had in just 1 month was immense. Like if my whatever I knew about web development, it increased at least 4 times. So I came to know, okay, you should do internships. One, because you learn a lot. Second, you come to know what exact skills inside web development also you need in the current corporate culture. And third, you get a very good experience. So after that, in my second semester, I pursued web development. Then I decided to explore something more. So my BTech has a specialization in cloud. And for guys who don't know what cloud is basically accessing your data, which is not stored on your personal PC or your phone. It's stored somewhere else and you access it through internet. So one of the easiest examples and which we use almost every day is Google Drive. So then I came across Amazon Web Services, which is one of the world's largest cloud providers. So I studied that for some time. And after that, I said, okay, now I should explore something a little more. So I started reading about different technologies such as machine learning, artificial intelligence, blockchain. But the USPs of blockchain actually stayed with me and I loved the things that this technology was solving. And then I said, okay, I think I should explore blockchain more. So to cut short and say you what, in simple words, what blockchain is basically storing data in a decentralized network in such a way that it cannot be tampered. So what do I mean by decentralized network? We are using a centralized network for now. So we have one server and we have many other users or nodes which are asking for information or giving information to that node. But in decentralized network, the power does not lie solely on the hands of one node, that is one server, but it is distributed among all the nodes. And these data are stored in a chain, and these data are actually connected through cryptography or in easier words, hashes. So if I try to tamper one block of data, then the subsequent blocks will also get tampered, and you cannot people will come to know, because you need a great more than 51% attack to tamper that data, which is not possible because each and every node has their own ledger or whole own chain of data. So the USPs of blockchain is trust, security, transparency, you know where the what are the transactions going on, security, and decentralization. So I thought of pursuing blockchain more. So Then I was confused. Okay, then which platform should I choose? After learning about the basics of blockchain and the consensus algorithms that are used in it, I decided, okay, now I have to choose a platform. So there are many platforms like Ethereum, Hyperledger, R3 Corda. So I seeked out for some help in LinkedIn, and then I decided that I think I should go with Ethereum because it's fairly easy to begin with. So, and then I can jump on other platforms if required. So I started developing small decentralized applications on Ethereum. My first decentralized application was where freelancers and the job providers can connect. So the market for freelancers is rising currently, and suppose I am a user and I want some freelancing work to be done, I'll post it in the application. The freelancers will choose which work they want to do and they will bid, okay, I will try to complete this work in 5 ethers. Ethers is a digital currency like blockchain, which is used in Ethereum. So then after I place my bid, the user who has placed the job will choose a bid according to his requirements. And then after the job is done, the payment can happen through Ether through that platform only. So then I thought, okay, through my web development internship, I learned a lot. So I think I should try for getting an internship in blockchain. So I got an internship in blockchain in a startup named Epic Knowledge Society, where we were trying to build an identity assurance decentralized application. We were trying to use sub-technologies such as zero-knowledge proofs and Oracleize. So zero-knowledge proofs are basically proving your data without giving the actual information. For example, if I go to a hotel and I want to prove that I am above 18 years of age, so I'll prove it that I am above 18 years without giving my Aadhaar card and without giving my exact age. Like, this is a small example. So we were trying to build an identity assurance app. I learned a lot during my internship. Now I am in, after I completed that internship, I was in sixth semester, and I decided to make a few dApps on Ethereum first before jumping onto another platform. So I built a decentralized application on real estate management. So the market of real estate is very large, and a lot of money is involved in it. So and plus lot of time is wasted in verification of details, personally I feel. Like, you have to verify so much that earlier this property belonged to whom, and now it's been transferred to me. I hope everything is transferred properly, and I hope there is no problem in this property. And the government, keeping a track of everything is also very problematic for government nowadays due to increase in the number of properties. So if we build a real estate management on blockchain, the verification part can be reduced because everything will be stored on blockchain, so there will be no tampering. The transactions can happen very fast through Ethereum, which will not be possible through rupees. And verification properties and search of properties can also be made easier. People can bid on properties faster. So all these problems were being solved through that real estate dApp, which I named as Shelter Hub. So after that, I bagged an internship in an MNC in cloud, which eventually got cancelled due to COVID-19. And then I decided, okay, let me take some time and strengthen my computer science fundamentals. Like, let me work on my data structures, algorithms, and operating systems, networking, and database. So I'm currently working on that, and I'm trying to strengthen my computer science fundamentals for now. My current plan is to get a job firstly, because I'm in my fourth year. So I'm looking for job opportunities such as software development engineer, or a full stack web developer, or a blockchain developer, or a Java developer. So yeah, and I'm hoping that whichever company I join, I'm able to contribute to the success of that company through my knowledge and skill set, and also learn along the path. I also want to contribute to open source more. I feel it's really important to give back to the community. I have personally been helped by my open source community through a lot. I am a part of a woman who code blockchain, and it has played a huge role in making me understand and explore more in blockchain. And I also got an opportunity to lead an Ethereum bootcamp right now. So I want to grab more of such opportunities and contribute to open source more. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much, Swati, for inviting me. It was a pleasure talking to you. Bye-bye.